Myanmar Junta fights culture by arresting it. See, this is what you do. If you really want to win the culture war, all you have to do is have the guns to arrest all of the people that are part of whatever culture you want to end. I mean, that's what it's all about. Myanmar has figured it out. They're going to win the culture war. I actually don't think they will win in this case, but they're going to give it a good try, and who knows, maybe they will. This is from cbc.ca. Myanmar authorities arrest country's best-known comedian amid ongoing crackdown. And I just want to go to this story because I get a little bit more meat for this one. Comedian and social activist Zarganar, pictured here in 2011, was arrested by Myanmar authorities on Tuesday in Yangon. Yep, that's what you do. See, if the Republicans had the gun power that the Democrats have, the Republicans would probably start arresting like Jeff Bezos and, well, maybe even, I don't know where Tyler Perry fits into the culture war. I don't know if he's DNC or what he is, but, you know, that's what they would do. That's what they would probably do. And if the DNC thought that they could get away with it, well, no, I think they are already doing that. The DNC is already in large part doing that. They are, whether it's arresting people or just using corporations to freeze people out of existence. That's the same net effect as being arrested. You're essentially no longer able to make a living. You're pretty much under a really extreme house arrest. Authorities in Myanmar arrested the country's best-known comedian on Tuesday as they continue to crack down on people they accuse of helping to incite nationwide protests against February's military coup. This is what all governments do. They just declare anybody that has dissenting views, this is why it's always dangerous if you think that you want to get into the business of trying to control quote-unquote misinformation and you give that power to a government. That government will always take that power and use it to quell all dissent. I keep trying to warn all you folks that are still aligned with the DNC, and I'm not saying go to the RNC, because I think the RNC might very well do the same thing at the DNC. As the DNC, if they had the power, and they have in various ways in the past. But if you're part of the DNC and you think you're safe, you're not safe. I'm telling you, unless you are near the top of the power structure, you are not safe, because at some point you're going to realize they're not going to come through with any of their promises. And then you're going to be like, wait, you're not. And then you, while you say right now you support the social media companies cutting off people for spreading misinformation and things that undermine democracy, that's going to be you. You're going to fit into that very category, you see, because the truth of government is in the guns that it possesses and how it can effectively use it against its own people, not in anything objective whatsoever. There's no objective truth in government other than violence. And if you could get that in your head, then maybe all of us poors, we could more readily find one another and realize that even most of the people marching out there on the, whether you're the Trumpians marching or whether you're the SJW, whatever you want to call them, marching, most of these people marching on those streets have far more in common with one another than they do with all of the people that are at the top that are whipping them into these frenzies of fear and hate. And Myanmar is a classic example. And keep watching Myanmar and see how people are dealing with this regime and how they're getting around it, because they are. More on that later.